Hey, what's up guys? This is Gowtham Raj from GRVWEB. So we have completed almost 5 tutorials on 2D. So this is our 6th tutorial of Staad V8i basics. So here we have some structure. This one is the structure which is having a floor load of -20.6 kilonewtons and also in 2 nodal loads of 36 kilonewtons, and we don't have any measurements, so let's assume the measurements be of 4 meters height of the column and the width of the beam is 5 meters. So let's get started with the work. So let's go to Staad Pro. Yes, minimize, yeah, new project. As we are using 3D, we are going to use space in this structure 1 2 CLASS 6. So go for next, add beam, finish. Here we just simply using transition repeat, so we can avoid lots of process. Just we have mentioned what was the height of the column. Height of the column is 4 and width of the beam is 5, and that's it. Hit escape. Now remove this grid. This is what we got. We are just using transition repeat. Press Ctrl A to select all the beams, nodes and everything. Go to transition repeat and we are going to repeat in Z direction. Number of steps is 1. The distance between the two columns is 5, as the width of the beam is 5. So I want to link the steps here. So hit OK here. So this is what we got. We just need to remove these two columns, I mean two beams at the bottom. So let's hit delete. Delete these two beams, okay. So this is a floor which is formed here. We can apply some floor load here on the top of it, and these are the columns, and this is we can consider like this is the ground floor and this is the top floor. So go to general, define a rectangle beam of 0.3 and 0.23, add it, and define a rectangle column of 0.4 and 0.3, add. Close this for now and assign to column. Go to select at the select menu, and this go to beams parallel to. The columns are the beams which are parallel to y-axis. These are the vertical members. So just go to beams parallel to y-axis and assign to selected beams. Yes. Now go to beams which are parallel to both x and z-axis. Go to select beams parallel to x-axis and even the beams parallel to z-axis. So we have selected entire floor. So assign. Yes. Now go to supports instead. It's very easy to assign supports in a single view. That is, even it may be a front view or whatever it may be, just create a fixed support. Edit. Go to front view and select the support. Select the nodes which you want to assign the supports. So assign to selected nodes. Assign. So if you go to 3D view, you can see the fixed supports has been assigned to all the 4 columns at the bottom. So let's go to loads and definitions, load case details, add a load case detail, add it and close it. Go to load case 1, add. Self-add is common for everything, so add it. Go to nodal load. The nodal load we have here is 36 kilonewtons as it is acting from the left to right. So we can directly mention it as 36 kilonewtons, in the x 36 kilonewtons, and add this nodal load and go to floor load. We have a floor load of minus 20.6 kilonewtons. Add it minus 20.6 kilonewtons, and the height of the building is, let be 6. It is asking for the maximum. You can give whatever it may be. You can give 66 or 600 or 6000, whatever it may be, but it should be the maximum height. You shouldn't give less than 5 or 4 or 3 or 2, because it should be the maximum height of the building. So 6 and 6 here, add, close this for now. When you have added a floor load will be automatically added to all the floors which are present in your structure. If you select this one, it will display the floor load. So yes, sulfate, assign sulfate to enter view, yes, and assign these nodal loads using your nodal cursor. Assign this one here and another one here. We have got the structure ready. So we go to design. We are designing for a concrete, so let's select our code book, that is IS 456 2000. In concrete, go to concrete. Here we can get IS 456, yes, and define parameters. FC, we are going to define FC as 30 m 30, 300 kilonewtons per meter square, and I want to add it. And FY main as 415 000, add it and close this for now. Go to commands, design beam and design column, and take off. Assign FC 300 to enter view, assign to view, yes, FY to enter view. Now we are going to assign this one to only the beams. So select the beams parallel to X axis, select the beams parallel to Z axis, and we are going to assign this one to the selected beams, yes. Now columns are the vertical members, so go to select beams parallel to Y axis and assign, yes. Now go to go to analysis print, add, close. Go to post print, define commands, analysis results, add, close. Go to analysis, run analysis, save. I have some problem with the Indian course in my software, so you will not get this problem in your PC or laptop, whatever it may be. Okay, I just get only one warning. The warnings can never be considered in 3D design, because it may be warning due to a one-way slab or one-way floor. This was the warning. This, you don't need to consider this one. If you get any error, just leave me a comment below on the YouTube. If you are watching this video on my website, just leave me a comment below, or you can mail me to info@gowthamraj.in, or you can also send your request through my website. Go to contact form and post your request and send it to me. I will respond to all your requests within 24 hours. Thank you guys. Thank you for watching my videos on YouTube. Bye for now.